drunk man Oldsmobile. They said had run the light that caused the six car pileup on 109 that night. When broken bodies lay about and blood was everywhere, the sirens screamed out eulogies for death was in the air. A mother trapped inside her car was heard above the noise. Her plaintive plea near split the air. Oh God, please spare my boys. She fought to loose her pinned hands. She struggled to get free. But Michael Petal held her fast in grim captivity. Her frightened eyes then focused on where the back seat once had been. But all she saw was broken glass and two children's seats crushed in. Her twins were nowhere to be seen. She did not hear them cry. And then she prayed they'd been thrown free. Oh God, don't let them die. Then firemen came and cut her loose. But when they searched the back, they found therein no little boys, but the seatbelts were intact. They thought the woman had gone mad and was traveling alone. But when they turned to question her, they discovered she was gone. Policemen saw her running wild and screaming above the noise, in beseeching supplication, please help me find my boys. They're 4 years old and wear blue shirts. Their jeans are blue to match. One cop spoke up, they're in my car and they don't have a scratch. They said their daddy put them there and gave them each a comb, then told them both to wait for mom to come and take them home. I've searched the area high and low, but I can't find their dad. He must have fled the scene, I guess, and that is very bad. The mother hugged the twins and said, while wiping out a tear, he could not flee the scene, you see, for he's been dead a year. The cop just looked confused and asked, now, how can that be true? The boy said, mommy, daddy came and left a kiss for you. He told us not to worry and that you would be alright. And then he put us in this car with a pretty flashing light. We wanted him to stay with us because we miss him so. But mommy, he just hugged us tight and he said he had to go. He said someday we'd understand and told us not to fuss. And he said to tell you, mommy, he's watching over us. The mother knew without a doubt that what they spoke was true. For she recalled their dad's last words, I will watch over you. The fireman's notes could not explain the twisted mangled car and how the three of them escaped without a single scar. But on the cop's report was spread, in print so very fine, an angel walked the beat today on Highway 109.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening. Blessed to be with you again this evening. First item we're going to do for you is God on the Mountain.
On the mountain, and you fall.
of the night. I know I had, I went to work yesterday morning. Got a WhatsApp message from my husband. Then when I got home, I was like, for real? I said, did you call? No, he didn't call. I made a phone call. He told me if I went to pay this money by 4:30, within the next few minutes, everything be started back out. So I rush. Sure, pay this thing, get back home, call, can't get through. Finally got through, said to me, okay, as it was now before I fight, everything be back in order. And I made sure I left my garage gate open, because it's locked my garage gate all the time. Because they have some youngsters, like when we first moved in the area, I used to leave it open every drive and come back in, but then my neighbor told me she saw some youngsters going on to the property and going on the north side. So I got a lock and I locked my gate. So I left it open in anticipation. Everything's going to be all right. Came back home and the problem was not fixed. It was not resolved. And all I said is, Lord, you deal with this.
Yeah.
And I went in the house. They know I had to do. WhatsApp my husband again, tell him you need to make another call. And they may cross the bed and sleep. And at 10:30 in the night, I heard my name being called. No, I'm a strong sleeper. I had set the alarm to wake me up at 11:30. And normally nobody can be up that easy. But all of a sudden I hear this voice calling my name. I jump on the bed, run to the door. My daughter bought her bedroom and she's saying, Mommy, well, I hear nobody call. I said, somebody out there just hear my name call. And she went back and bowed in front of me, look through the peephole now. And the next day, see her all up. Yes, Mommy, somebody out there. I said, yes, you see what time? And they went and they stand up and they watched until they were finished. Smile at that pretty, thank you very much. And you're not back inside my house. God is the God of the mountain and is the God of the valley. And he comes just in time.
Yes,
and you know, it's a trick. Satan is busy, you know, because I started, I say, you know something. This is going to happen Monday. It didn't happen Tuesday, Wednesday, or Thursday. But Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday is a bank holiday.
Yeah.
And then you come back to work. So Tuesday, devil is a liar. My God is the God of the mountain and he's the God of the valley. Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
At this time, by call Methodist will render us their rendition.
Promises of God.